Hi guys, I recently recovered, I guess, from a sad point in my life, and I just wanted to share that experience and let you know the tips that I learned along the way. So, I had been feeling really just down and sad and demotivated for a while, and I had no idea where this was coming from. I kind of gave myself reasons to think, oh, I'm sad because of this, or I'm sad because of that. But it just kind of kept getting worse when I thought that it might get better. I normally describe myself as a really happy person. If you ask me at any point of time, I'll be like, I'm happy, that's great, because I'm really grateful for everything that I have in life. But during that period, I just felt sad all the time. You ask me how am I feeling, and I just feel kind of deflated and sad. I don't really know how to explain it. It was just not myself. So I finally decided, okay, I really should talk to someone about this. It's probably just stress. I'm like constantly feeling like I'm just right behind the time, like I can't catch up really. So it's probably just that. But I know it's good to get like my mind kind of like off of it and just talk to someone else. So I did, but by the time I got to talk to someone else, it had just gone. Completely disappeared. Like, it had gone from like the day before where I was feeling terrible, ready to cry at any moment. That week was just so bad for me. And then the next day I was like, oh, well, something feels different. I feel normal. I feel happy again. I was like, what? Why? Why was there such a difference? And what had happened to me? And you know, after talking to someone and just thinking over it, I came to the conclusion that it was just a down portion in my life. I came to the conclusion that sometimes it's okay to not be okay. It could be like a seasonal thing. Maybe you feel down at certain points of the year. I know that in my school it happens during October. A lot of people are just like, oh, I feel so unmotivated. I feel really stressed. And that just happens in my school. And I think it's proven that it happens in like other schools too, that people feel down in October. So if you ever feel down in October, that could be like scientifically explained. but it could also be like, hey, holidays are over, and then, woo, New Year, but like nothing else to look forward after the New Year. Maybe you just have all this expectations of the holidays and then feel sad afterwards because there's nothing else. That could be something that just makes you feel down after all the excitement. Suddenly it's a new change and you feel down because of that. Or it could just be a down period in your life. I think that's what it was for me, that maybe a combination of some outside factors, like stress, some pressure I was putting on myself, other responsibilities, just made me feel really sad at that time, and it was just kind of like a sudden thing. Like I'm sad. I don't know, the body works in interesting ways, but to me it's kind of comforting to know that sometimes that just happens. Like, the world isn't gonna end because I felt sad for a short period of time, and it's okay, because I moved on and I went on to greater things. Not really, it's only been like a week. So based on what I felt, something really helpful to do if you're ever feeling this kind of not yourself way is probably to figure out what might be going on. This could be through writing or obviously talking to someone else. I like writing. I have my own journal where I just kind of spew out my feelings if I need to. I write a lot about little things, because really it makes things like easier to tackle, easier to understand when you have all of your feelings on just little words on a piece of paper instead of just keeping them and mulling them around in your mind. You know, sometimes things get lost up there. but then if you write it down, you can just have it all there and you can take a look at it and be like, well, these seems like things that make me feel sad, and here's some ways I can do something about that. The most important part about that is to, okay, after I've written it down, not to be like, oh, all these things are making me feel terrible. It's more like, what am I going to do about those things? How am I going to help myself feel better? If you don't like writing those things down, you could talk to someone else. That's like the standard advice for whenever you're feeling sad. It's just to find someone you want to talk to. For me, that person was someone that didn't really know me on a personal level. I was at this point where I'm like, I want an outside perspective. Someone to tell me from outside, looking in, what might be going on, and get me a perspective that I might not have already thought of myself. But for you, that might be someone personal, someone who can actually analyze what's going on in your life with you and help you figure out what's going on. Okay, so the last tip I have to offer is really helpful in making you take an outside look on yourself and just helping you like ground yourself and notice like the things around you and yourself. And this is called the GLAD technique. So GLAD, it is an acronym, and each one, you know, stands for something. So G stands for gratitude. I think gratitude is something so important to feel every day. So basically, just name something that you're thankful for. Today, I am thankful. Actually, I have always been thankful that my dog has never barked when I'm trying to film one of my videos. She's constantly barking, but it seems like when I'm filming a video, she decides that it's not time to bark, and I love that. I'm very grateful. The L stands for something that you've learned. It's relatively early in the morning for me. I've learned that I don't like turning on the light above me when I'm filming because I think it makes a lot of like shininess on my face. Moving on to the next one. The A stands for something that you've accomplished. So this could be kind of similar to learned, like learning something can be an accomplishment, or it could just be something really cool that happened. It doesn't have to be like a big thing, you got an award or something. It could just be a little accomplishment to yourself. Something I've accomplished is sitting here and making this video because I was totally distracted by webtoons like 30 minutes ago. Okay, and the last thing is delight. This could be something that's like really sweet and cute that happened, or I like to think that it can also be something that just makes you laugh, that brings you delight. Like I have to share, there's this one thing that really makes me laugh every single time. And you know those like air man people that are like in front of stores and they're just kind of like, there's air blowing up in them and they have these little arms and then they just kind of blow in the wind. I saw this one gif of a person cosplay, and it was like clearly in an anime convention, just cosplaying as one of those. It was totally like this, it was, it looks so realistic, but like underneath the costume, it's just a person like moving and like flapping their arms everywhere. It was really great. That was really weird. Hey guys, that was an example of the GLAD technique. So I hope that made you feel a little bit more glad today. Go ahead, try it out. You don't even have to be feeling sad to do it. It's just a great thing to do every day. I think it makes you feel a little bit more humble, a little bit more grounded, and just better about the day ahead. Or maybe makes you feel better at the end of the day, after you reflect on things that are going on. Okay, that is all I have for you guys. Thank you so much for making it all the way to the end of this video. I know that was a lot of rambling today, but I had a lot of fun talking about what makes me happy. I mean, I guess I was talking about what made me sad, but then I had a good ending. So I hope that encourages any of you who are going through a down period in your life. But I do have to add a serious note. If this has been more than just a down period in your life, but more of a long time, I encourage you just to seek some help or to talk to someone else about what's been going on. It's always good to dissect what's happening in your life and to figure out why you might be feeling sad. And to any of you are, I hope you feel happy soon, and I really hope this helps. Have a great day, you guys, and thank you for tuning in.